have my greetings and my wishes. Good morning, each and everyone who is watching or listening my classes regularly. And then up to this time, we have completed idioms and phrases and foreign expressions. Two topics, major topics, which are important topics, have been explained by me. They have been completed. Today, a new topic, which is most important in English literature, not a grammar, regarding to literature or English language, topic is figures of speech. This is the name of the figures of speech. Figures of speech in English language and English literature, so many genres are there, discourses are there, poetry, prose, novels, drama, play, skit, all these different genres are there, and creative expressions, the literature, entirely each and every language, then whole its own literature. Today's topic is figures of speech. Before going to discuss about the figures of speech, what is the necessary of the figures of speech? What is need in English language? Not only this English language, in each and every language, its own figures of speech. In day-to-day life, in conversation, we use many figures of speeches without notice ourselves. And that means a figure of speech is a word or a phrase. It may be a word or a phrase. A phrase means, do you know the meaning of the phrase? A phrase is a combination of more than one word. It gives some meaning. It is a part and parcel of a sentence. It does not have subject and predicate. It is called a phrase. That is the definition of the phrase. After letter, after word, and then a phrase, and then a clause, and then a sentence. This is the sequence. This is the sequence. A figure of speech is a word or phrase using figurative language that has other meaning than its normal definition, a literal definition. In other words, I am explaining about the figures of speech. The introduction of the figures of speech. In other words, figures of speech rely or implied. It implied or suggested that meaning rather than a dictionary definition. Entirely different from the dictionary definition. We express ourselves and develop them through hundreds of rhetorical. Rhetorical means a speech or writing. Rhetorical means a speech or writing to be the effective and influence people. That is a rhetorical. Rhetorical techniques means, that is the meaning of a rhetorical. Rhetorical techniques means a speech or writing to be effective or influential people. That is the rhetorical techniques. From specific types like similes and metaphors. Metaphors. In more general, like sarcasm and slang, these are figures of speech we are using in literature. Figures of speech make up a huge portion, a big portion, a large part of the English language. making it creative. Why we are using figures of speech? It create more expressive and just more interesting. The language is more interesting. Then otherwise it may be boring or it may be boring or exaggerated. That means there are countless figures of speech are there in every language, not only English language. All languages have some figures of speech, or many number of figures of speech are there. Innumerable or countless. And they fall into hundreds of categories. That is the meaning of the figures of speech. Figures of speech, any intentional deviation from literal statement or common usage that emphasizes, figures of speech emphasizes, clarifies, too easy to understand, to clear understanding, embellishes decorative in both written and spoken language. It is used in written and oral language or spoken language. That is more important. Figures of speech is, they are found in oral literature as well as polished poetry. It has been more used in the poetry, a poetic aspect. The poet using figures of speech while he was writing a poem and prose, and even in a speech, it attracts, it implied suggested meaning, rather it impress. Rhetorical techniques we have used while using the figures of speech in English language. That is more important. That is the introduction of the figures of speech. That is the introduction of the figures of speech. Next, we should discuss about the, there are innumerable figures of speech like metaphor, simile, metaphor. Why did we are discussing about first a simile? They have been used in day-to-day life daily. Simile, metaphor, simile, metaphor, personification, some of the figures of speech I have going to explain to you. I will read down first of all which we are going to discuss. Simile, metaphor, personification, metonymy, apostrophe, hyperbole, synecdoche, transferred epithets, euphemism, irony and sarcasm, pun, epigram, antithesis, oxymoron, litotetis, interrogation, exclamation, climax, anticlimax, anticlimax or bathos, alliteration, onomatopoeia, circumlocution, locution, tautology or pleonasm. Some of the figures of speech we are going to discuss upcoming classes. But today we are going to discuss the figures of speech. We are going to discuss in this session. First one is simile. Simile. What is the pronunciation? Simile. Sorry, simile. Okay, sorry. Simile. Simile. Simile means two unlike things. Here the definition is there. Are explicitly compared. Compared is more important here. Compared. Simile is introduced by words such as like, as. These two words are very important. And then we go to the real definition and explanation of the simile. Simile here, we are discussing about the simile. This one is we are going to discuss. Simile is, in simile two unlike things are explicitly compared. For example, one example they have given here. She is like a fairy. A simile is introduced by words such as like, or, as, so, as, etc. Here the example is, she is like a fairy. That means, here one of the figures of speech we have been discussing here. Today, this session, elaborate discussion to understand the students without confusion between the simile and the metaphor. The simile follows the metaphor, common figures of speech in the examples. Difference between the simile and the metaphor, I will explain you in clear-cut understanding. Don't be puzzled or confused. The definition of the simile, the explanation about the simile, a simile is a figure of speech that compares two different things in an interesting way. That is more important. A simile is one of the most common forms of figurative language. Figurative language, it is a decorative language. The language has beauty. It comes beauty to the language. A simile is a figurative language. These can be found just about anywhere from poems, when we are writing the songs and lyrics, and even in everyday conversation. Even though we are without our concern, we are using more and more similes and metaphors in our lives. We are using the figures of speech. Similes and metaphors are often confused with one another. We may be confused with one another. What is the main difference between the simile and metaphor? That simile uses the words like or as. These are more important. Like, as. You are like my mother when I have seen one of the women. Like as to draw a comparison with unlike things. But a metaphor simplify or states the comparison without using like or as. That is more important. Without using is called metaphor, and using like as simile. These similes are used in a literature to make writing more. Why do we use similes in literature? What is the need to use the literature by the writers or poets? More vivid and powerful. In everyday speech, these similes can be used to convey meaning quickly and effectively. That is more important. Our intention, our message has been gone among the public quickly and audience quickly and effectively. For example, one person is working very hard for the sake of his family, to improve his family. He is doing day and night working and doing hard working for the upliftment of his family. They are earning so much income to live a luxurious life. What do you call that person? He is as busy as bee. యాజ్ బిజీ బియుఎస్వై యాజ్ బిజీ యాజ్ బీ బీ ఈజ్ ఆల్వేస్ వెరీ డూయింగ్ ఇట్ ఈజ్ యాజ్ బి డూయింగ్ హార్డ్ వర్క్ ఈ ఈజ్ యాజ్ బిజీ యాజ్ ఎ బీ మీన్స్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ దట్ ఈజ్ వర్కింగ్ హార్డ్ వి కంపేరింగ్ బీ బిజీ దిస్ అడ్జెక్టివ్ కంపేర్స్ విత్ ద నౌన్ బీ ఇట్ మీన్స్ హీ వాజ్ వర్కింగ్ హార్డ్ అండ్ డే అండ్ నైట్ ఫర్ ద సేక్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ ఫ్యామిలీ యాజ్ బీస్ ఆర్ నోన్ టు బి అన్ ఎక్స్ట్రీమ్లీ బిజీ దిస్ ఈస్ ద ఇండికేషన్ ఆఫ్ బిజీనెస్ బిజీ ఈజ్ కంపేర్ టు ద బీ ద సిమిలీస్ కెన్ మేక్ అవర్ లాంగ్వేజ్ మోర్ డిస్క్రిప్టివ్ అండ్ ఎంజాయబుల్ మోర్ డిస్క్రిప్టివ్ అండ్ ఎంజాయబుల్ ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ షీ లైక్ ఏ రోజ్ షీ ఈజ్ లైక్ ఏ రోజ్ దట్ మీన్స్ షీఈజ్ లైక్ ఏ రోజ్ షీఈజ్ వెరీ బ్యూటిఫుల్ దిస్ ఈజ్ ఎ ఫిగరేటివ్ లాంగ్వేజ్ A figure of speech in which two unlike things are explicitly compared, which is called simile. The technique or simile, the technique of simile is known as a rhetorical analogy. Rhetorical, what is the meaning of rhetorical? I have already explained to you, what is the meaning of rhetorical? Rhetorical means a speech or writing to be effective and influence the people. That is the meaning of the rhetorical. The technique of simile is, why should we use simile in our day-to-day speech, in poems, in poetry, in prose? It's a rhetorical analogy as it is a device used for comparison. As fit as fiddle is. And he is as bright as the sun. He is sweating like a pig. As be pig. If can be an excellent way for an author, it is one of the way. It is one of the tool. This is the one of the weapon for the writer, for the author, either to make an unusual thing seem more familiar. The similes focus on a particular aspect of a comparison, so they may be hyperbole statement also sometimes. Hyperbole, exaggerated statement, hyperbole. They may be hyperbole statement also, the similes form on particular aspect in sometimes. From seeing over the top, contrast these sentences. You may be confused, it may be hyperbole. For example, she is as sweet as honey. As sweet. The sweet as compared with honey, honey is more sweet. Sometimes we may be like it is a hyperbole statement. It may be. You sing like an angel. He runs as fast as lightning. Writers often use similes. Why do writers often use similes? To introduce concrete images. For example, like boxes or Chocolates. About the abstract concepts. Life is a box of chocolates. That means, what is the meaning? Abstract concepts change into contract images. She is as sweet as honey means, this is abstract statement. The abstract statement change into concrete statement. We have already known different kinds of the nouns. Proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, and abstract noun, which is not your, we are not touchy, whatever the sense organs, abstract noun. He has a bravery. Bravery is an abstract noun. Happiness is an abstract noun. It is not a concrete noun. Nouns are only broadly two types only. Concrete nouns, abstract nouns. Concrete nouns may be like an object we can see, we can touch, we can feel. But abstract noun, it is at all possible. That is the meaning of the simile. That means, we have more. How do we understand the simile? How do we understand the simile? We understand the simile with the more and more examples. For example, you are as brave as a lion. He is as strong as an ox. As blind as a bat. A bear means bat is one of the animal creature. As cold as ice, as cool as cucumber, as innocent as lamb, L-A-M-B, lamb. As innocent as lamb, L-A-M-B, lamb. B is a silent. Lamb is a innocent. He is as innocent as lamb means he don't know. He has no awareness of particular field. As cool as black as coal, as proud as peacock. She is as proud as peacock. As silent as grave. Grave means who is a buried dead body, the grave. As quick as lightning. These are all examples, a comparison between unlike things. He is as tall as a tree, as tall as a tree. As tall as a giraffe. Actually, he is not a giraffe. Actually, he is not a tree. Abstract statements, we, through the simile, we express concrete statement to easily understand to the public, to the audience, to the readers. That is the meaning of. The simile is a figure of speech that compares two different things. And then we go to the next explanation. This is the simile we will. She is as sweet as honey. These can be often be found in songs and lyrics. Similes can be used for a wide variety of descriptions, from romantic and lovely as. They are common in poetry for their descriptive power. They are also common in other creative works such as speeches, novels, plays, because it is a kind of figurative language. They are used in situation in literal language is needed, such as technical writing and in laboratory manual. It is not used. It is not at all possible in technical writing or laboratory manual. Writers use simile in prose and in poetry and literary devices used in plain vivid imagery. For example, he looks like a fish out of water. Fish out of water mate, he is inconvenient. He is not adjust to, he joined, one of the person joined a job at first time, appointment. Our situation, his condition, he looks like a fish out of a water. Her eyes shone like a diamonds. She slept like a log, slept. The aeroplane soared like an eagle. It went like an eagle. That is the meaning of the simile. the figures of speech, all figures of speech are very important for the students in each and every examinations are there for our competitive examinations. Next, we discuss about this figurative language, more important, simile has been completed. I think you have understand this figures of speech, and we go to the next figure of speech, metaphor. This is the metaphor. Metaphor means, what is the definition of the metaphor? It is an informal and implied simile in which like, as, so are omitted. For example, he is like a lion. It is a simile. Here, like is there. It is simile. It is like. And he is a lion. Directly, he is a lion. It is called a metaphor in this example. That is the difference between the metaphor and simile. Metaphor, he is like a line. He is like a line. He is a line. Line is a metaphor. Metaphor is a figure of speech in which a word or phrase is implied to an object or action in which it is literally applicable. It is an expression often found in literature that describes a person or object, referring it to something that is considered to have similar characteristics, same characteristics, when you are comparing to that person's or object. For example, the mind is an ocean. The city is a jungle of both. Metaphors and simile are the most commonly used figurative speech in everyday life, in everyday language. Both are very important. We are using in day-to-day life. It is an expression that describes a metaphor, a person or object by referring to something that is considered to possess similar characteristic. That is more important. Similar characteristics. Both come. A figure of speech in which a word or phrase literally denotes one kind of object or idea is used in place of another to suggest a likeness, analogy between them. Broadly, it is a figurative language. What is the mind? His mind is an ocean, means it's a figurative language. Ocean means he has abundant knowledge. He is a man of letters. He is an intelligent person, intellectual person. Without saying that adjective, we should use an ocean. Directly we compare. He is an ocean. Metaphor means an image, a symbol, an analogy, allegory, a conceit, an embellish. For writers have been selecting while writing the poetry, writers use metaphors to add color or emphasis to what they are trying to express. For instance, if you say someone has a sea of knowledge, we are using metaphor to express how smart or educated they are. Sea of knowledge means? Knowledge and sea are not literally related, but they are figuratively related, sea and knowledge. Because are both immense things that are different in meaning. By putting them together, we can concrete or we can concentrate how a person's knowledge. How was a person's knowledge when comparing the sea of He has sea of knowledge, abundant knowledge. That means abundant knowledge. For example, the snow is white blanket. He is a shining star. Directly we are speaking without using like or as. It is a metaphor. Her long hair was a flowing golden river. Your calm lake was a mirror. All the world is a stage. The entire world is a stage. All men and women, merely we are all players on the stage. We are all actors on the stage. All religions and arts and sciences are branches of the same tree. These are the metaphors. These are the figurative language. This is the figurative language. That means, here we discuss about the figurative language, metaphor, through the examples. Yeah, without knowing, without notice, we are using the figurative language in day-to-day conversation. Not only poetry and prose also. Day-to-day conversation. And then, how do you understand the difference between simile and figures of speech? Metaphor, simile and metaphor. I will explain you at the concluding end of the class, difference between once again. For example, we take one example. My brother is a couch potato. Couch potato. C-O-U-C-H, couch potato. My brother is a couch potato. My brother is a couch potato. This is one of the idioms. We have already discussed some of the idioms and phrases. What is the meaning of couch potato? Do you know the meaning of the couch potato, my dear students who are listening to this class? My brother is a couch potato means he is a lazy and inactive person. He is not participating actively in any field. That is the meaning of the couch potato. That is the concrete, abstract statement to have been changed into concrete statements. It is called a metaphor or a simile. For example, my teacher is a dragon. Dragon. My teacher is a dragon. My teacher is a dragon. D-R-A-G-O-N. Dragon. Dragon means a mythical monster like a giant reptile. This is one of the meaning. That means it is literal meaning. That is literal meaning. And figurative is he is a strict man, strict person. That is the meaning of the figurative meaning. In figures of speech, figurative meaning is more. He is a pig when he eats. That means he eats like a pig. It is raining cats and dogs, which is one of the, already we have discussed about the idioms and phrases. Cats and dogs means, what is the meaning of cats and dogs? We have already discussed cats and dogs. Cats and dogs. What is the meaning of cats and dogs? It is one of the idiom. It is raining cats and dogs means it is raining heavily. Heavily rain. Their home was a prison. That means they are facing a difficulty in their homes, problems. Life is a fashion show. Time is money. The teacher planted the seed of wisdom. That means the teacher posed the knowledge among the minds of the students. She cut him down with her words. That means his words, through these words, he bothered, heartfelt words. The clouds sailed across the sky, sailing. Your brain is a computer, means you are very intellectual, very fast. Your mind is very fast to take any decision. Your brain is a computer. It is a concrete meaning. My brother is a couch potato means he is a lazy person, he is not participating actively in any field, any act. For example, his heart is a rock means she is very He has no mercy. He has no generosity. He is very rude. That type is his heart is. He has no kind. He has no the quality, the positive. There is no any positive quality. His heart is rock. He has no mercy among the people. She is a shining star. The thunder was a lion. Lion roaring. The thunder is roaring. The words are, her words were bullets to him. That type of aspects we are expecting. And then before going to complete, for example, he has a heart of gold. Gold means he is putting gold in his heart, you think? It is a literal meaning, not a figurative meaning. That means he is a kind, loving person. That is the figurative meaning. He has a heart of gold means he is a kind person, he is a lovely person. Her voice is music to my ears. That means her voice, speech, sounds very pleasant and happy. He is walking, he is a working, he is walking encyclopedia. That means encyclopedia contains everything is there. So much knowledge is there, belongs to all subjects. He is a walking encyclopedia. Walking encyclopedia means, what is the meaning? Why do we learn the figures of speech? When we go to any meeting or conference or debate, they have given the speech and the time they are using number of metaphors, similes, hyperbole, metonymy. How do we understand? We don't understand. They are using phrases, idioms, figures of speech. They are using more figures of speech. He is a walking encyclopedia, means he has so much knowledge in his mind. For example, you are my sunshine, my dear, you are my sunshine. I am talking about my friend, we are discussing, I am uttering the words, the statement about my friend, you are my sunshine. You are my sunshine means? Sunshine means happy and bright. For example, the world is a stage. This world is a stage. It is a platform. It is a dais. That means people's lives. They are full of drama. After completion of drama, we get down from the dais. We leave the dais or stage. That is the metaphor. Metaphor, the difference between simile and metaphor, I will explain and then I conclude this class. Simile compares two different things by using like or as. You should remember that thing. Where a metaphor states that something is something without using like or as. That is mainly two different. That figurative language is a technique of that for the writers and poets. That surcharges our reading, reader's imagination. Imagination, factual statement and injecting it with a color We adding color and humor to make it more interesting. That is the figurative language. Okay, thank you, my dear students. I hope myself, I am very satisfied to explain two figurative speeches. One is simile and another one is metaphor. I hope you should clear about both two things. Thank you one and all once again. Goodbye all of you. See you.